Protect your DNA. BioPQQ can promote formation of new mitochondria. Infowarsstore.com.
Well, it has not been the best season for Colin Kaepernick. Perhaps not the most memorable or the most memorable, depends on how he wants to look at it. But once again, he has opened his mouth to the chagrin of many NFL fans. Now, when Colin Kaepernick took the field on Sunday to play Miami, he was met with thousands of boos after he praised Fidel Castro hours before his death and even wore a shirt adorned with the Cuban dictator's face. So once again, Colin Kaepernick having to make political statements on the sports platform, something that I'll comment on here in a little bit, but for him, I think it has turned out negatively. Now, Kiko Alonso has been said to turn his bad blood for Colin Kaepernick into a great performance. Now, Kiko Alonso is the second generation American from his Cuban exiled father. And it was Kiko Alonso who says that Colin Kaepernick, his mouth essentially motivated Alonso to put in a great performance. So Kaepernick's mouth cost him again. Kiko Alonso delivered the game-winning tackle on Colin Kaepernick on Sunday. And then after he made the tackle, he adorned a Cuban flag on a headband and met with his Cuban exile father and other family members to enjoy his productive day. Alonso went on and talked about how he had strong feelings about what Kaepernick said, and he carried those feelings into the game. It makes me wonder if there were other players who shared similar feelings that they also brought into the game when they played Colin Kaepernick. I know myself, if I was in that circumstance, I might have a little bit of added aggression towards the quarterback, if you will. And then Kiko also chimed in saying that Colin Kaepernick, he's ignorant. And I think that that's exactly what it is. And here's the thing about this for me. I actually support what Colin Kaepernick is doing here. He's trying to ingest real issues using his platform of sports media. I guess my issue is just how he's done it. I don't think that the protest of the national anthem was the greatest thing. I don't think he's very well educated on some of the things that he's protesting. Nonetheless, we are starting to get this conversation going and this rhetoric started amongst these athletes. Kiko Alonso chimes in and stands up for the people of Cuba who were mistreated by Fidel Castro, which Colin Kaepernick went on to ignorantly praise. Now, more on Colin Kaepernick. Again, he loses this Sunday. The player who makes the game-winning tackle says that he had extra motivation. Actually, he said in this story he wanted to hit Colin Kaepernick because of the comments he made about Fidel Castro. But it gets worse for Colin Kaepernick. That loss on Sunday is a record. The 49ers set franchise record for consecutive losses, 10 straight losses for the Niners this year. That is a record in their 70 years of existence. Never have they lost 10 straight games. Do you think that that might be a little bit of karma there for Colin Kaepernick and the Niners? I would also guess that in 70 years of the 49ers' existence as a franchise, they have never had anybody protest the national anthem. So I'm just saying that's another coincidence. The strange thing about this that I recall, players used to cry during the national anthem. I remember then the cameraman used to flash on the sideline and there would be streams rolling down the player's face because they knew how blessed they were to be in this country. They knew that the opportunity to be a professional football player or any athlete really probably only existed for them or the best opportunities in this country. It's funny how far we've came from a country who would cry during the national anthem to now a football player who wants to cry and then protest the national anthem. But this is costing the NFL in the ratings, and they are now considering canceling Thursday night football. So protests by the NFL players against the country on the rise, and what do you know? The ratings go down. And of course, to me, if we could get Americans to have the same passion for freedom, for their country, for truth, and for justice as they do for their favorite NFL football team, we could turn this country around like that. This is Owen Schroyer for Infowars.com.
You think our information's hardcore? You think our focus is brutal? Try our nutraceuticals. Try our supplements. We've taken Brain Force and made it Brain Force Plus. Now a 20% more in the bottle and an even more hardcore formula. You owe it to yourself to get these products. They really have worked for myself, my family. They have 5-star reviews by the thousands. Secure your Brain Force Plus today at InfowarsLife.com. Now 20% stronger. Again, InfowarsLife.com.